गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर. सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द व्हाट इज द क्रिस्टल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ए सॉलिड. ओके, व्हाट इज क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड एंड व्हाट इज अमॉर्फस सॉलिड. सो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न नाउ क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स. सो अमॉर्फस सॉलिड्स आर द नॉट हैविंग द regular arrangement of atoms and molecules, but in crystalline solid atoms and ions are arranged in the regular and periodic manner. Okay, so this is we are going to learn about the crystalline solid in this unit. So and in previous video lecture I think we have learned this, what is lattice. Lattice is a periodic arrangement of atoms in a crystal. So this point is known as your lattice points. Okay, so this is two dimensional arrangement and this is three dimensional arrangement. Two dimensional arrangement is known as your plane lattice and this three dimensional arrangement is known as your space lattice. And we also learn about what is crystal structure. Crystal structure is a combination of lattice plus basis. So lattice, that is the lattice point, and basis means it is a group of atoms or molecules or ions. That each lattice point there will be a basis. So this lattice plus basis forms a crystal structure. So we'll start now. What is unit cell? So unit cell, that is the minimum volume of a solid which repetition generates a complete crystal structure. So here observe that this structure is a minimum volume structure and whose continuous repetition will generate this whole crystal structure. That means ek same structure ko agar apan repeat karte jayenge to usse kya banega, pura crystal structure banega. Aur wo jo structure hai uska volume kya hona chahiye, it should have the minimum volume. So minimum volume solid structure whose continuous repetition in three dimension, okay, will generate a crystal structure. So that is your unit cell. Here this is your FCC unit cell. This one is your, so atoms at corners as well as one atom is at the face of that cubic face, center of the face. Okay, so if you practically this is the shown according to the understanding, but actually central atom having, this one is your central atom which is attached to the other atoms. So this contribution is only 1/4 for this atom also, this atom also 1/4. Okay, so this is about your unit cell. So there are two type of unit cell. First is your primitive and second is your non-primitive. So primitive means if there are lattice point lies at this corners. Okay, here lattice points are at corner, then this unit cell is known as your primitive unit cell. And if the lattice points at the corner as well as lies inside that unit cell, and this is the minimum volume structure whose continuous repetition generates the crystal structure. So minimum volume structure having lattice point at corner as well as inside, then that unit cell is known as your non-primitive unit cell. Okay, so what is the condition for unit cell? It should have the minimum volume and whose continuous repetition will generate the entire crystal. Okay, so this is about your unit cell. Now if you consider this is the crystal structure, or these are the lattice points in two dimension. So if this structure I have to represent, I requires the translational vectors. Okay, so these are A vector and B vector are the translational vectors. It is in two dimension, this is the two dimensional structure. So if it is two dimensional, then it is known as your plane lattice. Okay, and if it is three dimensional, then it is known as your space lattice. So in two dimension there are two axes. This is the first axis and this one is your second axis. Okay, so suppose A vector is a translational vector along first axis and B vector is a translational vector along second axis. You can take it as a vector is a translational vector along x axis and B vector is the translational vector along any x y axis also, because this is the two dimensional, so it requires only two axes. And what is this? This is the gamma, which is the angle between these two translational vectors, a vector and b vector. So this is the representation of a unit cell in terms of translational vectors, and this is the angle between two translational vectors. So in two dimension, it is known as your plane lattice. And if it is three dimension, in three dimension, there will be three axes, x, y, and z. Okay. So here it is. This one is your x axis, this one is your y axis, and this one is your z axis. Okay. So there in space lattice, there are three axes. So we require three translational vector, a vector, b vector, and c vector. These are the translational vectors along three axes. It will be x axis, this will be y for y axis, and this will be for the z axis. And suppose this is the unit cell whose continuous representation generates the crystal structure entire. So this volume of this unit cell is a that this one is given by a vector cross b vector dot c vector, and their magnitude is taken. Okay. So this is the formula to determine the volume of that space lattice. Okay. And how to calculate this area of this area means it has two sides. So area, it has three sides, there will be volume. So here how the area will be a vector cross b vector. So their cross product will act as a area of occupied by this small unit cell. Okay. Or it is occupied by the this unit cell occupies in a plane lattice. So this is about your plane lattice and space lattice. And remember that in plane lattice we require only two vectors, a vector and b vectors, while in space lattice we require three translational vector, a vector, b vector, and c vector. And in two dimension, the volume is a vector, that area is a vector cross b vector. In space lattice we have required the volume. The volume will be a cross product of these two vector and combinedly dot product with the c vector. So this is about your unit cell. Now we will going to learn what is symmetry operation. So symmetry operation means that if you apply any operation to the particular crystal structure, the crystal structure will remain same. Okay. यानी क्या होता है, अगर आपने क्रिस्टल स्ट्रक्चर को किसी पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन में रोटेट करने के बाद भी क्रिस्टल कैसे लगना चाहिए, सेम लगना चाहिए, उसमें कुछ चेंजेस हो ऐसे दिखाई दे देना चाहिए. सो सिमेट्री ऑपरेशन इज दैट विच ट्रांसफॉर्म द क्रिस्टल टू इटसेल्फ. सो आफ्टर रोटेशन और आफ्टर सिमेट्री ऑपरेशन क्रिस्टल विल बी लुक लाइक सेम. सो देन इट इज नोन एज योर सो वी कैन से दैट द क्रिस्टल रिमेन्स इनवेरिएंट इन द सिमेट्री ऑपरेशन. So there are four symmetry operation: translational, rotational, reflection, and inversion. So this inversion is only applicable for three dimension, and this translational, rotational, and reflection, these are applicable in two dimensional as well as three dimension. So what is translational symmetry operation means? If you consider a 7, this 7 is motif is formed by using the suppose if you use the pen here. So suppose this is your first lattice point, this one is your second lattice point, and this one is your suppose third lattice point. If you join these two lattice points, this will be like, will look like 7. So this 7 is known as your motif, and if this motif is continuously repeated in one particular direction, it will generate the complete crystal structure. Okay. So in this way, if the motif is repeated infinite number of times in translational symmetry, then it is known as the translational symmetry operation, and it is in only one direction. If motif can be repeated and structure remains invariant, then it is known as your translational symmetry operation. Okay. So that is, if you draw a 7, and this 7, if you draw again lattice point, and this will be look like again 7, then again it will be look like 7. So this same structure will be repeated. So that is, motif can be repeated in translational translational operation. Then we say that crystal structure represent the translational operation. Similarly, we will going to learn about what is rotational operation. So it is look like a structure. If you that structure will rotated by certain angle, the crystal will look as same. Here if observe that if you rotate this structure by 180 degree, this point will goes to this side, this point will goes to this side. So but what happens, the crystal will looks like same. So that is known as your two-fold symmetry or rotational symmetry operation. So here observe that in case of ammonia, here if you rotate this by 120 degree, this point to this point, then crystal structure will remain same. Again, if you rotated this point to this point, crystal structure will repeated will be same. So here we can rotated this structure by 120 degree. 120 degree if you rotated, it's look like your fan. If you rotate it by 120 degree, we say that the position will be same of the fans. Okay, so this is your rotational symmetry operation, and in rotational symmetry operation we can have for one fold symmetry rotational symmetry operation, two fold, three fold, four fold and six fold, but five fold symmetry operation is not there. You have proof for this in your textbook, you have to refer it. Okay, so rotational symmetry operation means if the crystal will remain same after rotating by rotational symmetry operation or by rotating it by certain angle, then it is known as your rotational symmetry operation. And how much time you can rotate it, that will defines the value of that n also. Okay, so this is about your rotational symmetry operation. And second is the reflection. Reflection means there should be a plane in a crystal such that the left hand side image will be look like a right hand side. So left side in mirror, our left side and front side image right side, both are in same direction. Okay, so that is there exists a plane in which the which divides it into two identical half, which are mirror images of each other. So crystal is that if you rotate the crystal, so the crystals will or if you take a certain plane in a crystal that divides the crystal into two identical halves and both are mirror images of each other, then that symmetry operation is known as your reflection symmetry operation. Okay, and inversion means if the if it is in first quadrant, then it looks like same in third quadrant. So the light is said to be passes inverse symmetry operation if there exists a plane which in which lattice divides it into two identical half. Okay, so we have to draw a certain plane in a crystal structure and one half is a inverse image of the other half. Okay, so that is the about your inversion symmetry operation. In two dimension, these three operation symmetry operations are there, but in three dimension we'll get all symmetry operations. Okay, so this is about your symmetry operation, and now we'll going to learn some of the point group. So what is point group? So it is a lattice point group, that is the collection of symmetry operation which when applied a lattice point leaves the lattice invariant. So this is the if you apply symmetry operation particular crystal structure, it will remains invariant. So that lattice point group is known as your point group. Okay, so group of symmetry operation at point is called a point group. So in two dimension there are 10 point groups, and in three dimension there are 32 point groups. So in two dimension these are the your symmetry operation, that is a one fold rotational symmetry operation. This is one fold symmetry operation, and one is one mirror plane is there. So in this way, this is about your point group. And in space group, there it is a three dimensional. So in three dimension there are 230 space group, in two dimension there are 17 space groups, and in two dimension there are 10 point groups are there, while in three dimension there are 32 point groups are there. So what is space group? Space group is characterized by the Bravais lattice and by location of the point group and other symmetry elements in the unit cell. So this is about your symmetry operation, and in next lecture we are going to learn about the Bravais lattice. So try to revise this portion and study and stay safe, stay in home. Okay, and continue your study. So I will stop here. Thank you.